Hello again, everyone. This is Rudolph Wilkins with Forgotten Fitness, and today I'll be describing and demonstrating a classic full body exercise routine designed for the working man. Depending on your job or lifestyle, you may be very limited on free time, especially when it comes to gym training. If this is the case, I have the perfect routine for you. The Busybody routine by Dave Draper allows you to more than adequately train your entire body in 1 hour or less. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns about this particular exercise routine, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. And with all that out of the way, I hope you all enjoy this video. This program can be found on page 81 of Brother Iron, Sister Steel, and is specifically designed for the novice lifter. It is to be done 3 times a week on alternating days, and should take no more than 1 hour to complete. It relies exclusively on free weights as to familiarize the participant with the exercises and movement patterns. Dave's advice to all is even if you only have a couple of pairs of dumbbells and a barbell, make it work and get excited about your workout. You are creating a habit that will hopefully last a lifetime. One tip he gives is you should stay focused and be diligent, and also have fun. You want to create a natural chemistry between yourself and the iron. This is a beginner program, as I mentioned earlier, which uses the superset technique. That is, you will do 2 complementary exercises back to back. An example of this would be exercise 1 followed by exercise 2, pause for weight adjustment, and a 30 to 60 second break, and then get back at it. You will continue this pattern until all sets of the exercises are complete. When starting, you will begin with just 1 or 2 sets of each exercise, with the goal of 3 by the end of month 1. You also want to use a weight that is manageable, but challenging at the same time. And most importantly, form is everything. You want to make sure that your body is adjusting to what you are doing and this new habit you are creating. Now I will go over the routine itself in a little more detail. While I won't be demonstrating it here, you do want to perform 2 to 3 sets of crunches or knee-ups as a warm-up. As I mentioned, this will be a superset routine, so exercise number 1 and 2 will be done together. You'll begin with the bench press, followed by stiff arm dumbbell pullovers for 1 to 4 sets with varying numbers of reps. On bench press, you will do sets of 12, 10, 10, and 8 reps, gradually moving up in weight, and for stiff arm dumbbell pullovers, you will stay at 10 reps. Exercise 3, to work the back, is the bent over barbell row, for between 1 to 4 sets of 8 to 10 reps. Exercise 4 and 5 will be done together as a superset, and this will be to work the arms, barbell curls, and dips between chairs. You will do 1 to 4 sets of each for 8 to 10 reps on barbell curls, or 10 to 12 reps or maximum, that is a complete failure set, on dips. Exercise 6 and 7 will also be done together as a superset. Here you will be working the legs, performing a light bar squat for 2 to 4 sets of 15 reps, and the toe raise off the block. This is a 2x4, and I will demonstrate this, of course, for you, for 2 to 4 sets of 15 to 20 reps. Now I will show you the exercises themselves. Starting off is the bench press, which, as Dave Draper describes, is the patriarch of weightlifting, and one of the best exercises you can do for the chest. You want to begin this exercise by lying on your back, and grasping a racked barbell with a grip slightly wider than shoulder width. Then you will press the barbell off of the rack and then bring it down slowly to the chest, right at your pec line. Then you will press the bar deliberately and slowly back to the starting position. You want to work both the concentric and eccentric portions of the lift to make sure you are working the pectoral muscles fully. Another thing that's very important is you want to focus on the muscles involved here, that being the chest in particular. You want to find that groove that works for you, and everybody's a little different. So if you've never done this exercise before, make sure to practice. There's no failure first starting out. You always have time to recorrect and try your best to improve. This is one of those exercises that you grow and perform better over time. Now we will move on to exercise number 2. Exercise number 2, which is the exercise we will perform in combination with the bench press, is the stiff arm pullover. This will be performed with a dumbbell, and is what Dave Draper describes as a feel-good power stretch that engages the lats, the biceps and triceps, the pectoralis muscles, and helps build serratus muscles like a mason builds a wall of stone. When supersetting this, it is extremely gratifying and productive, especially over time because you can literally see your ribcage develop and stretch like nothing else. This is one of the best exercises I think you can perform for the entirety of the upper body. To perform it, you simply lie on your back with your head at one end of the bench and your feet at the other. Grasp a dumbbell over your head, press it up, and then you will bring it all the way behind your head, rotating at the shoulders but keeping the elbows locked, and then bring it back to the starting position. This exercise is incredibly satisfying and rewarding, and perfectly pairs with the bench press. Now we will go on to exercise number 3. Exercise number 3 is the bent over barbell row, but this variation is a little bit different from what you're probably used to. Here the torso will act sort of like a lever, whereby you will stand with your feet relatively close together, and then bend at the hips so that your rib cage is in contact with your thighs. Then with your back flat and your eyes focused forward, you will grasp a barbell, if it is an Olympic barbell, 6 inches from the collars, but in this case I am actually using a standard 1-inch barbell. You will then settle into position, and then focus on the grip so that you are able to get a tight contraction in the middle of your back. In doing this, you should bring the barbell up to mid-chest height, squeeze, and then return the barbell as to not touch the bottom of the floor. You actually want to have the barbell hover just short of tapping the floor, and then you will continue with the prescribed number of reps. You want to focus heavily on the negative here, making sure that you get a stretch and squeeze all the way from the top to the bottom, and perform this at a medium speed. This is one of the best exercises you can do for the back, and is a must-have exercise in any routine, especially if you don't have a cable station. Now we will move on to exercise number 4. Exercise number 4 makes up part of the second superset here, and is the tried and true barbell curl. If for any reason this exercise gives you pain in the wrists, you can switch over to doing an easy bar curl or a dumbbell curl instead. For this exercise, you want to stand with your feet slightly wider than shoulder width, with your arms completely extended before beginning. Then you will curl the bar up, using only the biceps, making sure you are making somewhat of a semicircular pattern, until the bar reaches shoulder height. Then you will return it to the starting position. This is an incredibly reliable exercise to build mass on the biceps, and is what I believe to be probably one of the best bicep builders there is as far as targeting the entirety of the muscle. Now we will move on to exercise number 5. Exercise number 5 is dips between chairs. Now it should be quite obvious that I am not using chairs. Instead, I have chosen to use parallette bars, which I find to be much more comfortable. Now, essentially all you're trying to do here is, if you're using chairs, you will have your palms flat on the seat of the chair, have your body sort of leaned in between like I am here. You will have your legs out in front of you, and you will bring your body all the way down, flexing at the elbows and the shoulders. You should slightly rotate your shoulders forward and make sure you're putting a lot of pressure on the triceps rather than the chest, because we've already done chest in that we have worked the bench press. Now we are doing a tricep exercise, so this is more of a tricep dip. Then once you're at that low position, you will press back up, making sure to fully extend at the top. A simple yet very effective exercise that works the triceps incredibly well. Now we will move on to exercise number 6. Exercise number 6 is another heavy hitter, in the squat. This is an exercise designed for full body growth, not just the legs. It adds power and mass to the legs and helps improve athletic performance. The accent for the squat, the main thing we're trying to focus on, is the glutes and the quadriceps, but the hamstrings and the calves work as well. You want to begin by placing a bar on your traps and shoulders, padded if you choose, such as a rolled towel. Then you will slowly lower yourself down as if you're about to sit in a chair. You will then bring your body all the way down so that your quadriceps are parallel with the floor and your feet are flat. Then you will pause for a brief second before bringing yourself back up following this same pattern. This will be essentially a leg thrust, where you will be pushing off the ground, bringing your body back up. For breathing, you will inhale as you descend and exhale as you ascend. You will repeat this for the prescribed number of reps. Now we will move on to the final exercise in this routine. The final exercise in this routine, and the exercise you will superset with the squat, is the toe raise or calf raise. For this exercise, you will place a 2x4 on the ground, and then you will place your toes on the 2x4, and simply use your calves to elevate your body up. If you choose, you can put weight on your back in a barbell, or you can hold two dumbbells by your side to add resistance. However, the main thing you're trying to do is get a lot of reps in. It's really important when developing the calves that you do a lot of repetitions to work the fast twitch fibers as well as the slow twitch fibers if you're trying to do heavier weight. This is a really great exercise and a fine addition to this routine. But that's all I have for you today. If you all have any questions, comments, or concerns about this exercise routine, or have any future video ideas, please leave them in the comment section below. And until next time, this is Forgotten Fitness signing out. Bye-bye.